So if you're new to plant-based eating or eating a vegan diet, then this video is definitely for you because today I'm going to be taking you through the five essential pantry items that you're going to want to keep on hand when you're eating vegan. These pantry essentials pack a ton of nutrition and flavor, and I know that having them on hand is going to make a world of difference for you in your vegan kitchen. So follow me to the kitchen and let me show you exactly what I mean. So first up, we've got some raw nuts and seeds, and nuts and seeds have a variety of nutrition, different micronutrients, as well as a ton of energy and protein to keep you going throughout your day. Now, if you're somebody who is wanting to maintain their weight while they go plant-based, or maybe even gain weight through muscle mass, nuts and seeds are going to be essential for you to increasing the amount of energy that you are having in your meals on a daily basis. I like to include a variety of nuts and seeds, including flax seeds and walnuts for the omega-3. Also, Brazil nuts are super high in selenium, and so those are something that I like to focus on throughout the week as well. Now, if you're somebody who is looking to lose a bit of weight, if you're coming to plant-based eating with a few extra pounds, then I'd recommend limiting the amount of nuts and seeds that you consume on a daily basis, at least until you reach your goal. Because as I said, they are very calorie dense, and if you're snacking on almonds, snacking on walnuts, things like that throughout the day, then you may not reach your goals as quickly as you had hoped. Next up, we have our whole grains, and I love having a variety of whole grains on hand. My go-tos are brown rice and oats. Those tend to be the ones that I reach for more often than not. But you know, don't be afraid to expand your whole grains as well into ones that maybe you're not as familiar with. Couscous is a really good example, and that one is actually really quick to come together as well. You're not waiting an hour for brown rice to cook if you're just using couscous. It can take maybe even 10 minutes to make a batch of couscous. So that's a really good one to have on hand if you're short on time and if you're not really into the batch cooking. For me, what I do is I'll make a huge pot of brown rice and I'll freeze half in a large Ziploc bag, which is easy to break up once it's frozen. I'll just make sure that it's nice and flat. And then I'll use that when I need some rice and some soup or something else, maybe a stew or a curry. And then I'll have the other half of that huge pot of brown rice in the fridge, which I can use for Buddha bowls or stir fries or whatever it is that I'm throwing together throughout the week. Quick oats are an awesome thing to have on hand, especially if you're a really busy person like myself. Often I'll have overnight oats, or I'll make like a berry cobbler for a dessert. That's really easy to do. You can make your own oatmeal bars, own muffins. And of course, there's just good old oatmeal in the morning for breakfast. That's always a really good option also. Next up is to have a variety of dried fruits on hand. And just like with nuts and seeds, dry fruits also are very calorically dense. And so this is another awesome option to include if you're looking to maintain your weight on a plant-based diet. Having a variety of dried fruits, it's really easy to pack in a lot of calories in a small amount of food. So it's great for people looking to gain weight or looking to maintain their weight. And the same caveat goes here for the people who are looking to lose weight. I would limit the amount of dried fruits you're having. So that's the raisins, cranberries, dried apricots, all of that good stuff. Limit the amount you're having every week until you reach your goal. But dried fruits are awesome to have on hand. You can dehydrate your own. I made a video a while back about crabapple rings. We have a huge crabapple tree in the backyard, and so last year the kids and I sliced them all up and we dehydrated them. And I've been using them in my overnight oats in the mornings, and they're such a nice treat. They rehydrate overnight, and it's just really easy to throw together and to get that extra nutrition. Dates are one of my favorite natural sweeteners. They are very high in sugar, but they're also very high in fiber. And so when that sugar is attached to fiber, it really drops the glycemic load. So where you're having a tablespoon of brown sugar or coconut sugar or whatever it is, and you swap that out with a tablespoon of date paste, which is just blended dates with water, the glycemic load will go down. And it's a great natural way to sweeten your foods up. Next up is TVP, and stands for textured vegetable protein. I know that sounds really weird, but it comes from soy, and what it is these dehydrated granules. So you can purchase TVP in these granule form. I usually get mine through Bob's Red Mill. I'll leave a link for you guys in the description down below, so if you want to check it out what it is that I'm talking about. You can also get it at a lot of bulk food stores. So here in Canada, we have Bulk Barn, and you can get it there as well. And TVP, what it is, it's dehydrated soy, and it's awesome because it's completely shelf stable. It's a pure source of protein, very low calorie, super inexpensive, which is great. And the cool thing about TVP is you can rehydrate it with any flavor you want. So if you wanted to have a beef flavored TVP, for example, you can rehydrate that with maybe some mushroom broth with a bit of tomato paste mixed in to get that umami. If you wanted maybe like a ground chicken or ground turkey feel, you could add a bit of poultry seasoning and some vegetable broth and rehydrate it that way. And so it's really cool. It's similar to tofu in the way that it will take on whatever flavor that you're cooking with it. So very cool. I often will add this into a spaghetti sauce to make a bolognese. I've used it as taco meat as well, and it's just really quick, really easy. It takes maybe 5 minutes to rehydrate, and so I love having that on hand. And finally, we have got some seasonings. So here I'm just gonna showcase a few seasonings that you might not be familiar with if you're new to plant-based eating or to the vegan lifestyle. So first up is nutritional yeast. Nutritional yeast is a fan favorite among plant-based eaters and vegans alike. And nutritional yeast is really special because it has a super cheesy flavor to it. It's also very high in protein, and a lot of the time nutritional yeast will have a high content of vitamin B12 as well. Although, quick caveat here, I do recommend that you take an actual B12 supplement when you're eating plant-based rather than relying on nutritional yeast for it, just because that way you know exactly what dose you're getting when you're taking that supplement. I'll link some recipes for you guys down below so you can have a peek at how I actually use these ingredients in my own vegan kitchen as well. Soy sauce, I know you guys know what soy sauce is, so I'm not gonna spend too much time here, but I wanted to highlight it because vegans and plant-based eaters will often use soy sauce or liquid aminos, which comes from coconut, as an umami booster. So it has that really meaty flavor that is awesome to go with any kind of burgers that you're making, or you can use it in that bolognese, you know, maybe add a few dashes to the liquid that you're using to rehydrate your TVP. You can soak your tofu in it. Just be careful because sometimes obviously it's very high in sodium, and so you'd want to go a little bit mixed in with some other seasonings that you're using. I wouldn't rely only on soy sauce as your only seasoning in the dish that you're making. And finally, an extra special ingredient. This one is called black salt, also known as Kala Namak. And this is an Indian spice. And what it is, it's a salt that is very high in sulfur. And so you'll see this ingredient a lot in vegan recipes that are eggy. So I've used it in my vegan hollandaise sauce. I use it a lot in my tofu scrambles or in my chickpea omelets because it really gives that eggy flavor to the point where oftentimes omnivores can't really even tell the difference between the tofu scramble that I've made and scrambled egg because it has that amazing flavor. So I really encourage you to give black salt a try if you're missing that flavor. You can use it in potato salad, you can use it in pasta salads, just to highlight that egginess that you may be missing in your diet now. Again, I'll leave links to some of these products down below just so you can kind of take a look and figure out what exactly it is that I'm talking about. Oftentimes you can buy these things in store. Nutritional yeast you can get through Bob's Red Mill. I have it at my local superstore here. Black salt I haven't found in store at my big box stores that I usually go to, but I know you can find it at specialty stores, specialty spice stores, and I'll leave a link for you to the one that I purchased online as well.
And as a bonus for you guys, of course, we're gonna wanna have a lot of dried lentils and dried beans on hand.
So I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Let me know if you'd like a full tour. I've been thinking about doing like a fridge tour or a pantry tour, just so you guys can kind of get a behind the scenes look of what it is that I use to kind of cook my family meals with. So let me know if you'd like that video. If you guys give me a like or leave me a comment down below, then I'll get working on that right away for you. If you liked this video, please be sure to give it a like and share it with a friend, because that way I know what to focus on producing for you guys. This channel is all about you and teaching you how you can eat healthfully in your kitchen. So I want to make sure that I'm producing content that's valuable to you, okay? Thanks so much for joining me on this one, and I'll see you soon in the next one.